really just need to look at the training data a lot of times, and you can sort of be able to determine whether you can call BS or not. Garbage in, garbage out. This quote that Carl showed really sort of gets me shaking and kind of a little bit upset, because it's the fact that algorithms and machine learning approaches don't have bias is just simply not true. The Calvin and Hobbes really represented this really well in a little cartoon. I'll let you read it so I don't interrupt, but I'll read it in case you can't see it in the back. I'm filling out a reader survey for Chewing Magazine. See, they asked how much money I spend on gum each week, so I put $500. For my age, I put 43. And when they asked me what my favorite color is, I wrote garlic curry. This magazine should have some amusing ads soon. I love messing with data. So the point here is that, I've messed with data too, and these companies use this information, and so of course you would expect that a lot of the results are going to be silly. But then it gets kind of serious. I keep being kind of the serious guy this quarter, although I'm not always that serious, but this is serious. This was some work that was done by Latano Sweeney at Harvard. She did a very simple exercise. It turned out to be not so simple because it led to all sorts of important analysis, which is if you were to search LaTanya, a name just starts with LaTanya, in Google, some of the ads that you would get would be arrested. You'd have public, you'll have these public records ads that you'd want to look for. If you did something instead of using LaTanya, you use Jill as the first name. You might start to see things about art, also you find public records, but it's in a different kind of form. So algorithms do have biases. They do have even worse, and I would claim, and I think many of my colleagues would claim, even worse than humans. Now, there are other kinds of biases that exist. A lot of companies might have inherent geographic biases. So they might say that if you're further from our particular office, maybe you're in a neighborhood that you might have to take a bus or you take a train. They might sort of look at that as sort of being from a poorer neighborhood. Not they, explicitly, but the algorithms have, there's been evidence showing that. There's been some nice articles written in the popular press and in the research talking about the machine bias that's being used by judges to try to reduce recidivism. But of course, as you would expect, there's incredible bias, and it's something we should take note. There's been some good articles. At least this is getting recognized. We're starting to see the community sort of come together and say that we really need to think about this in more depth. There's a nice paper here on looking at sort of the semantics in all the natural language processing work that's being done in computer science. It's wonderful work. One of the more important things that we're finding is the bias that exists during this extraction process. There was a paper written here by one of the professors in HCDE, Sean Munson, basically did a very simple thing. Said, what percentage of all CEOs are women? Well, found out 27%. But if you go and look at the percentage of women of CEO images on Google search, the top 100, what do you see? Much lower than the actual percentage.
Something that's sort of dangerous about these algorithms, which is that if a person that you're working with is racist or sexist or whatever, they're culpable, right? You can call them out on it. People try to avoid acting in these ways, and you can take action against them. There's sanctions against them. No such thing with an algorithm. An algorithm's not culpable. If an algorithm is acting racist, it doesn't know to be ashamed of that or to not do it, and you can't punish it. It's just there. And I think that makes these things particularly pervasive, because these algorithms sort of legitimize racist and sexist behavior in our society.
That's right. It's a really important point, and that sort of brings us to the end of the lecture today on calling BS and big data. Couple other examples real quick. Even our Google Translate algorithms, this really powerful method for translating, you find if you take this Turkish phrase, and Turkish, for those that know Turkish, is gender neutral, and if you have it translated into English, what do you notice? He is a doctor, she is a nurse. So there's gender bias already in the translators that we're using. If you put that same thing in down here and translate it to Spanish, you get es un doctor, I was doing an accent, that was terrible. Es un doctor, which is the male form, but this just messes up. It's a hamster RA, I don't know what that is. But the other thing that the algorithms do so poorly is we get into these echo chambers. We're gonna talk a little bit about this when we talk in natural ecology. The last thing I want to end with is this to you. Calling bullshit on machine injustice is something that you can do as a society. These are the issues. Thanks for listening today.